Special guest of the evening, but the first DJ DB Effect and Soul Theory. What's up, boys? What's happening?
What's up?
Cool, cool. So welcome to the show. What's been on the agenda? What you guys been
up to? We jumped in Europe for a couple of weeks.
We just did Radost this past Saturday.
Oh, Radost in town, in Prague?
Yeah, it went really well.
Okay.
And right before that, we were in Hungary.
Yeah, big gigs in Hungary.
And then Brno on Saturday, right?
I don't actually know yet, as my manager. Kind of. We got some TV shows going to come up too. So.
Okay, so you're on the road, big style promoting. Yep. What exactly? What's the latest release?
The collaboration, definitely Mos Def.
Met up in New York a few years back at a show, actually. And we've been working together since. And we got a lot of things coming out with Rex. Who else? Knowledge Medina.
A lot of project. Actually, Rex is DJ on Hip Hop Camp, and also Soul Theory is DJ, so the connections are real tight between the artists, as well as Soul Theory with Rex, me and Soul Theory, all that.
Okay.
Rex and I have a project in the works also called Sleep When I'm Gone.
Sleep When You're Gone?
Yeah, I'm producing the entire project.
Okay, and you...
I wrote some tracks, that's fire.
Yeah, and Soul Theory, you produced a few tracks and also featured lyrically on the More Grey Hairs, right?
I produced a track on More Grey Hairs and Grey Hairs.
Okay.
Money on the Ave with Sky Zoo on Grey Hairs, and we did the remix on More Grey Hairs with Terminology and Sky Zoo.
Terminology also on Hip Hop Camp.
Yeah, what?
It's all the same click.
Exactly, plug.
Yeah.
So we're in the studio, we're going to get into some live stuff a little bit later, but before we do, DB Effect, like, talk the tech heads through exactly what you're working with, because you've unpacked a whole bunch of stuff.
I'm always hearing... Actually, basically, I got two turntables, so I need more space. But I'm keeping it simple today. So just one turntable, mixer, and kind of MPC. It's called an MPD. That's about the same thing, but with a laptop. So real quick, we're doing beats live. We're like chopping the samples live and all that stuff.
Taking it kind of way back, but also futuristic with the technology.
Of, yeah.
And traveling light, I see, which is all right.
Let's go.
Okay, so... So we're going to get into some live stuff. Before we do, we can talk to you about some forthcoming parties, so you guys can get ready, set up.
Yeah.
And we can do the normal Best Damn Rap Show banter.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so we're going to do some sound checks and make sure that everything's
okay.
Kosher.
Okay, let's go.
One, two. We still in the game till the money burn. The money, the power, respect is the only ones that I be wanting, cause S is the only one. For DJ, DB Effect, and my dog go hard on the decks. Hard for respect. You got the spit bars, it's hard on your neck. It's all for the check, huh? Cut it up, my song's in the deck, Turn it up, yeah. Cause the game ain't nothing. These lames can catch flames, the rain ain't coming. Your man can get tanked the same way fronting. Your team could get aimed at, could get linked back, For each way, DJ, DB, affecting you, scratching on the track. It's like that, y'all. Soul Theory, in the fire.
DB Effect, I'm capable of anything.
Last year was much more about a project than playing, so it was really interesting.
So have you ever been part of a DJ crew or wait for something?
That was a crew with a lot of people. So I've been, you know, just seeing those people. I had my own crew. That was a super cool. That's history now.
Future looking forward. So, Song Theory, can you talk us through the On the Come Up series?
Myself and my artist, Charlotte Medina, and I produced the entire project. It's 12 songs long. Real good music, real life inspired music, and the production is actually a real soulful type of style. And I was Medina, a very strong lyricist and artist, and we're actually a group called KS Flow. And the name of the album is On the Come Up.
Cool. So this is out and available now?
Yeah, it's available everywhere online, iTunes, Napster, you know, Rhapsody, any of those you can think of. And, you know, we also have the stores in the U.S. as well.
Okay. So, as a MC and lyricist, which came first? MC and producer, sorry. Producing first or writing?
I was actually an MC from the beginning, originally. Shortly after that, I started getting into beats. That's actually what took off for me first. And, but now that I've been doing that for a while, I'm starting to get more back into the MCing thing as well. Yeah.
So which do you prefer? Which do you find easier?
From the beginning, beats was kind of my bread and butter, you know, because that's what's basically made the most of my living. Mm-hmm. You know, so, you know, if I had to choose one, it would be that for now, you know, but that could change in the upcoming, you know, because I'm really going to be going hard with the on the mic in these coming years.
Cool.
Yeah.
You got to be get behind, and I can tell you that the new tracks are crazy on the project was Rex.
Oh yeah? So how did this whole Rex collaboration come about?
Rex, that's actually my homeboy, you know. We were in Miami together. He moved down there from Boston, you know, which is where he's originally from, to be with his wife and kid. And so we linked up, and we really just started getting in the studio, doing tracks, and the chemistry was there. So, you know, and we outside of the studio, we were chilling hard, so we really, you know, just connected and we get it in.
So I get the feeling that the whole movement of you boys is that it's just a clique that really get on well, work together.
We all believe in the same thing, you know, real music.